Hi, Sam Bell here for Guitar Interactive magazine, and I'm here today with this gorgeous Takamine acoustic guitar. This is a dreadnought style acoustic with loads of great features. Before we get into this, let's just talk about Takamine. They're known for their high quality acoustic instruments based in Japan. And this is a Japanese build Takamine. So this is in the upper range of the acoustics they offer. Takamine has been around for many years and has a bit of a legendary status in acoustic guitars. They've become quite collectible. Players such as Bruce Springsteen has been known to use their acoustic guitars, and for good reason. They last a long time, they're high quality, well built, and they sound great. So let's take a look at some of the features. Let's start with the headstock end of the guitar, and we have a slotted headstock. So that means the strings go into the tuners like a sort of classical style guitar. And if I turn the guitar sideways, we can actually see these tuners with a nice pearl machine heads and gold hardware. So it looks fantastic, really lovely quality to the finish. They feel great as well. Good ratio on those tuners. I'll be writing up in detail all of the details of all the ratios and the radiuses and all those details, but it is a classic style guitar, so things like the radius and the body woods and everything are all to go for that classic vintage sound and style. So the neck is an Ovenkohl fretboard, okay, and we have vintage style frets. We've got a double fret dot there on the seventh fret, so that's a great look on the guitar, and 12th fret of course as well. It's a nice round, almost D-shape neck, a lot to get into there, but the frets are very sort of the medium and quite wide as well, but they feel really nice. It's quite a comfortable guitar for the strumming and the open chords, and that mixed with the slanted headstock as well. The headstock actually angles back slightly there into the slotted machine heads, and that gives us more resonance on the open strings of this guitar. So if I play some nice open string voicings, maybe let's try D sus 2. Now for this review, I'm going direct into the desk, and the preamp on here is all set to zero, so we'll talk about that in a moment, but we will be miking this guitar up at the end of this review with an AKG 414 microphone, which is a typical mic'd up setup, so hopefully you get to hear this guitar in many different situations. Okay, so moving on to the body, we have a solid thermal spruce top, and you can see the grain in the wood there looks lovely, and then you've got a tortoiseshell style pickguard there. Now the side and the back are solid sapele. You can see there, so it's a different wood grain, different colour. And all this adds to the vintagey tone of this classic style instrument. So within this, of course, as well, we have our preamp. And this is one of Takamine's own preamps. It is aptly named the CT4B2. Okay, so this has the 9-volt battery, a 3-band EQ, and the volume. And of course, we have a built-in tuner here. And as you can see, I need to tune my E string like so. So a decent preamp, and the back strap button is where you plug in the 1/4-inch jack. We've also got a strap button underneath here on the neck joint, the heel of the neck. So you can, it's not completely classic. Normally a classic guitar would let you just tie a piece of string around the headstock there, but no, we've got a good sturdy strap button right there on the heel. It doesn't get in the way. And of course, because it's the Dreadnought style body, we only really get up to the 12th fret and the 13th fret maybe for the upper end work. With that being said, let me do some playing now with our mid-range of the guitar, so we can actually get a bit of an idea of the tone. And I think the single note stuff actually really feels nice to play. The action on this guitar has been set up wonderfully. It's not a super flat radius. It's got a bit of a radius, I'd say probably about 12 inch. There was no stats on Takamine's website or any other websites to actually demonstrate the actual precision of the radius, but it is flat enough, but round enough to get the open chords, but flat enough to get some nice sustain on single notes. So all right, let's try it out with a microphone. We're going to be using an AKG-414, which is the classic kind of studio microphone that you'd end up miking up this kind of guitar with in the studio. We're placing it around here in the sound hole and between the fingerboard. Just to let you know, I'm using a thinnish kind of pick. It's about 0.73, it says. So a thin pick gives you a bit more of a crisper sound and lets the chords kind of ring out with more clarity. So just to keep that in mind as well, that also affects the tone. Let's just have a listen to it with the microphone. And that's pretty much it. So we, the only thing really to add, we have obviously 20 frets here, but not all are accessible, but the quality still remains. And it comes with a really solid hard case. And as I say, it's in the upper register of sort of acoustic guitar market. Probably not as far as some other ones, but just it's in the high quality bracket. You're paying for what you get here, definitely. The quality is exactly what you get. And the sound, the feel, the build quality, the features, the hardware are all in place there. So if you're looking for a Dreadnought style guitar for your guitar collection, I highly recommend checking out the Takamine CRN-TS1 model Dreadnought acoustic from Takamine. Japanese made, good shout. All right, I've been Sam Bell here at Guitar Interactive Magazine, and we'll hope to see you soon. Thank you for checking out this video. We really hope you enjoyed it. If you want to see more cool quality content from Guitar Interactive Magazine, then please subscribe and hit the notification bell below. We've got tons of lessons, interviews, gear reviews, and many other features to come. Check out these videos here as well. We look forward to seeing you soon.